Hi there, I'm Lucas Troy, and this is Ask Swagelok. I'm joined today at the Solon Tech Center by Matt Dixon, one of our fluid sampling experts, and we're talking about liquid samplings and how to do that effectively into cylinders. So, Matt, when we talk about sampling into cylinders, how does the sampling procedure actually affect the sample itself?
Yeah, absolutely. The sample procedure can definitely impact the size of the vapor space. The biggest factor is going to be the sample supply pressure, but the procedure can exacerbate the effects of the supply pressure. Mm-hmm. So for example, the worst case scenario, the scenario that's going to result in the smallest possible vapor space, would be if we close the sample return valve, but left the sample supply valve open. What that'll do is it'll allow the sample supply pressure to keep pushing liquid into the cylinder, mm-hmm. further compressing the vapor space. Ideally, what would happen is that we would close both of those valves at the same time, which would really minimize the impact that pressure has on the vapor space compression. So we could adjust our sampling procedure, instructing the operator to close those valves together. Mm-hmm. Or alternatively, we could alter the design of the panel, linking those valves together with some sort of a linkage or a geared valve assembly of some sort to force those valves to be operated together, mm-hmm. and to make sure that we are not allowing that sample supply to continually compress that vapor space.
All right. Well, thanks, Matt. And thank you guys for joining us for Ask Swagelok.